Okay, so in the rest of the lectures, what we're going to be talking about is different sources of aggression. And so in this lecture, we'll be concentrating on cultural sources of aggression. The first source of aggression is a culture of honor. And in a culture of honor, honor must be defended with violence. So this is a painting of a duel between two of America's founding fathers, Alexander Hamilton and Aaron Burr. And the idea behind a duel was that you could only defend yourself by aggressing against somebody else. And so you would challenge somebody to a duel if you felt like your honor had been impugned. So this is kind of a historical example of a culture of honor, but of course there are contemporary examples of cultures of honor. Specifically, gangs are great places to see a culture of honor, where if you say something bad about a gang member or somebody who's related to a gang member, something like that, the only way for that gang member to regain his or her honor is to aggress against you. And so there are historical examples, there are contemporary examples, and you can think of lots of different examples probably of where people feel like the only way to get back is to get even. And that's a culture of honor. We've already talked about relative deprivation, so I'm going to talk through this fairly quickly. Essentially, the reason why relative deprivation causes intergroup bias is the same reason it causes aggression. Because if you feel like you have less than other people, then you're going to be mad at those people and you might aggress toward them.